the love of money. But don't get it twisted, still clocking big digits. I'm Rodeo, big spending. All the cribs, luxury. I can't recall the last time I did dishes, big business. All my deals, six figures and up. When you get it out the mud, it hit different. Used to sell when the cops came, we hit fences. Now I'm blowing smoke out the country with two thick. I'ma take them both back to the penthouse and get. That's how it's supposed to be. Life is beautiful, I'm doing. I don't believe. Flew out to Colombia and brought me home some.
It's Madden NFL.
Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Kansas City. Taken at the goal line. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. So here come the Dolphins now as they get set to take over on offense. They will be led out by the 6-foot lefty from Alabama. It's Tua Tagovailoa.
Every quarterback in the NFL has a little bit of his own signature style out there, but for this guy, he really plays the game in a different way. It's led to a couple double takes from us up here as we see him as something truly unique. It's not that he's just the strongest passer or the best athlete to ever play the position. He just has a certain way of seeing the action and allows him to make some special plays out there.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down. They'll run. Here's Devon Achane. And a missed tackle there as he pushes forward for a gain of 4.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. There's the former Chief, man they watched for years, Tyreek Hill. 23 yards the pickup there. Their first possession of the game, and they're already going after double coverage.
That's a nice completion that can set the tone for things to come if they're able to keep finding ways to beat what the defense is throwing at them. They look like they're confident that they can get it done.
Give them a couple on the carry there, second and 8. Now Tua. Over the middle and complete to Waddle. It'll go as a gain of 4. And that'll make it third down.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short game.
And he won't get close. Only a yard, 4th and 3.
He may be a bit undersized compared to the modern-day NFL defensive tackle, but what he lacks in size, he definitely makes up for in his ability to make tackles in the run game as well.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. He's got his target. That's complete. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. Wow, 1st and goal, and defensively all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well.
I tell you what, this is not for the faint of heart right here. 4th down, this is taking a big risk, but it's as good a play call as you can imagine. And the defense, just not able to come up with the stop they needed. And this is not just a 1st down, but a big play as well.
1st and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Mostert, he is going nowhere in a hurry as he is going to lose yardage here in a big way. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. And this is going to be intercepted. Mike Edwards puts it up. And the Chiefs are going to take possession here. It's a touchback. And they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Not something you see very often from a quarterback of his caliber, an opening drive interception.
Oh, there's no doubt in my mind that even he's surprised at how that one played out.
but we know this game.
And this intercepted on the first play of the game. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Well, their defense got them to football with an interception. They trot out there, Charles, in the very first play. They give the football right back.
Brandon, I almost expect you coming like an auctioneer. We've got two, we got two. Do I hear three? Remember, it was two in a row. Would we hit three in a row? Because these offenses, they've got to be a little bit more careful as they go forward. These defenders, they're locked in and really focused.
They hand it off to Mostert. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Derek Nottie makes the tackle.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Touchdown, Dolphins! Tyreek Hill on the touchdown pass from Tua. And the Dolphins are on the board first here on the road in Kansas City.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control. And how about the end result? A touchdown.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And it's now a 7-0 game.
Jason Sanders to kick off for Miami.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
On second down, here's Mahomes. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Give him 13 yards there and a Kansas City first down.
That's good for our Kansas City Chiefs. First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter from Arrowhead. It's the Chiefs in possession. As they've got it with a first and 10. Now the Georgia Southern man, this is Jarek McKinnon. And a lane slow and materializing there as he'll get maybe a yard up to the 45. They work now on second and 9. Now they'll throw with Mahomes. To Valdez-Scantling over the middle. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion. And that'll bring us to a 3rd and 4.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be 4th and 4 inches.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be 4th and short.
On is the punter, Townsend, as he gets this one away. Yeah, he was looking for the checkup bounce, didn't get it. That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. Now we get Tyreek Hill and the rest of the Miami offense back out there.
He's doing what he's capable of, having a solid game. Not the most amazing game. He's not over 100 yards, but a good game so far.
And you just know that mentally, he feels like he's one catch away from turning it into a great game and starting on that road. And the defenders are well aware of that, too. They've got to figure out a way to not let that escalate. Keep him right in this zone here and call it a day, because otherwise, he can really decimate him.
Better believe they are well aware of his playmaking ability. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains.
throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. They go back to the ground, this time Mostert. And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line. A Miami first down, that one going for a gain of 11. They went counter there offensively, and a couple of defenders were on skates for a second.
They certainly were, and you know what offensive linemen love about the counters and the misdirections? Sometimes you don't even have to block the defender. He can run himself out of the play if he doesn't read his keys properly.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Now a second and 10. A run straight ahead with Achane. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
Well, this play sequence was really kind of called in reverse. Incomplete pass on 1st and 10. Nice run on 2nd and 10 when probably everyone was expecting them to throw the football. Now, if you're the defense, what are they going to do on 3rd down? You're a little off balance.
Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have the Dolphins 1st down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert here on 3rd and 3.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a 1st down.
Now Achane on 1st and 10. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's 2nd and 12. Here's Tua. Oh, it's intercepted. A drive killer there. Picked off by Legarius Sneed. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. An excellent play there, CD, on the pick six. And I think did they have an extra DB out there?
Yeah, Brandon, I think they were in standard nickel, not the Buffalo, as teams like to call it, meaning 3 safeties for big nickel. They just want to take one of the quarterback's throwing lanes, and that's exactly what they did and came through with a big-time pick six.
So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away. Braxton Berrios selected to bring it out. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. 30 seconds remain in this first half as they come up here 1st and 10. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And he's not going to go anywhere as they get him down behind the line of scrimmage. The Dolphins moving with a sense of urgency here. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
So many times we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
And he's going to come up well short as they rally up to stop him at about the 16. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with 4th down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say, we'll see what happens. Shedding through the defense. So a touchdown apiece. That's what we have to show. Well, that came a little abruptly here. Still working on my Apple up in the booth. Hang on here. Let me spit this out. And we can get to the 3rd quarter now. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 along alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to fight. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play in Chris to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Mahomes now on first down. That's complete. It's Travis Kelce. Mahomes finding his tight end Kelce for a big one. 42 yards.
He just had the feeling that sooner or later somebody was going to come up with that one play. Neither team has really done a whole lot offensively, but here's one that pays off to the tune of big yardage, and it's one that could maybe get this group in gear.
And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. So three plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. They go play action. Now Mahomes. And that's caught. It's Kelce. Touchdown, Kansas City. A 5-yard touchdown catch. And the Chiefs have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that makes the score 14-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Berrios going to bring this out of the end zone. And they're going to start in a hole as he's brought down at the 11. So here are the Dolphins now. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. Well, Charles, you and I said in intermission, feels like we're set up for a good second half. Well, the other side scored. Now it's up to them to answer. How do they respond here with their first drive of the second half?
Bottom line is they just saw the ball go in the end zone against their defense, and they saw what good offense looks like. They believe they've got a good offense as well. Run the best plays you've got to the top performers you have and try to move that ball down the field for an answering score.
And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked up by Justin Reed. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. So after the INT, here's Mahomes. It's Kelce on the ground. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. Second and a couple. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And this pass caught by Gray. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up the first down.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. They've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is that right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Call that a very strong gain of 24. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. 3 plays, 3 pass completions, in the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hit in this game, didn't it, for them to get downfield that quickly. And now first and goal, expect them to attack right here on this play.
And Mahomes is going to keep it. And maybe the wrong read there as he's going to go down immediately. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. It's second and goal, back to the 8-yard line now. Here's Mahomes to throw. That's into a crowd and intercepted. And the Dolphins are going to take over at their own 11-yard line. So this offense moving the ball well, trying to open up a two-score lead here in the third quarter, but now potentially a play that could have big ramifications.
Yeah, you've driven the ball down the field. Things are looking up, but it takes just one bad decision to throw things off the rails.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. On the ground, it's Mostert to start the drive. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand. And that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
Tua going to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion. We couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day. One score game. First and 10 here. They'll run right side with Mostert. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Three quarters in the books. This is the National Football League. We're back now in KC. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the fourth. They fake the handoff. Now Tua. He'll let this go deep for Waddle. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Trying to get a big strike right there and hopefully tie this game up in the late game. But the coverage was there, and this winds up incomplete.
The Dolphins on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 44 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Brandon, unfortunately, I've been here before. They've had 2 opportunities to stop them, so this is demoralizing. They haven't gotten it done. Now you're calling all your blitzes, all your attack defenses, but you're not worried about playing your normal position. You're going to take chances now.
Well, you said it. 2 third-down opportunities to get off the field. Couldn't do it, and the clock continues to roll. A run with Mostert up the middle. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run, the best runs for the top running back. Those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
The offense on third down tonight, they've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. They're looking at third and a few inches. On the handoff, this is Mostert. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up in the backfield. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame whooping has turned into results.
They'll go. Achane. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he shorted the line to gain. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up 1st and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Going across the middle, and Valdez-Scantling has it. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for 1st and 10. On play action, it's Mahomes. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Bradley Chubb doing what he does best, getting that sack.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
Mahomes going to throw. Got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. Now wind up getting 10 back there as it'll leave them with a 3rd and 5.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on 1st down. They didn't get all of it back. But now they look at 3rd down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. Oh, no, he lost the football. And that was ball picked up by the offense. But here in the final 2 minutes of the game, this will be blown dead. Only the fumbler can advance the football. So this will go back to the spot of the fumble itself. And that ball popped free. We could hear it all the way up here. Those guys down on the field alerting everyone to the fumble. He's lucky that his offensive mates picked him up and jumped on it.
Yeah, and you have to think to yourself, and I'm sure they've been echoing it on the sideline and into the huddle. Guys, we have the lead. Just take care of the football. Don't make it easier for them to start to make a comeback.
They'll come up first and 10 here. Tua. And that one incomplete, but now a penalty flag coming in late. That might be PI.
Defense.
So the defense helping him out a little bit here late in the fourth.
Yeah, exactly right. And when you're the one doing the chasing, you'll take a little help from the other guys, won't you?
Here's Tua. Got a man. It's Berrios complete. Here's second down. Now Tua. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. Still going. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he says, we're walking off the field. Want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit. And that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
So this one in the win column for Kansas City. And, you know, it wasn't a shutout. They did give up the points in the first quarter. But